Children of Standard 4, today we are going to discuss our fourth chapter, that is How Animals Survive. Children, in this chapter we will come to know that survival for an animal is an adaptability of that animal to its environment. So many times we see the different kinds of habitats of the different organisms. You must know the term habitat. The habitat means the natural environment or place where an animal or plant lives. Some plants live on terrestrial land. Some plants grow in aquatic medium. And in our previous classes, we saw many kinds of animal that live in desert, like camel. We see many kinds of animals that live on trees. So these are the different kinds of habitats for the different kinds of animals and plants. So our earth has different kinds of places. Many places are ice cold regions. Some places are green land. Some places are desert and oceans. But all these regions of our land has a variety of flora and fauna. So, what is flora? All the plants come in the flora category, and fauna means all the animals of the earth come to fauna category. Millions of years ago, children, the dinosaurs roamed the earth. Now they do not exist anymore. Why? Because they could not adapt themselves to their environment. So what is adaptation? What is adaptation? You can see that the process of changing to survive in the environment is called adaptation. Like plants, animals are also found everywhere on the earth. They are adapted to survive in their surroundings. When there are changes in the surroundings, such as change in climate, animals also have to change their place and behavior to survive. And all of us know that dinosaur could not adapt themselves to the changes in their environment. So they do not exist anymore, and now they are known as extinct animals. Extinct means they are not found on this earth. So adaptation is necessary for any organism to survive in any environment. For their survival, adaptation is needed. For example, a penguin's body is well adapted to survive in extremely cold regions, while a crocodile is adapted to live in swampy areas. So an adaptation might take hundreds or thousands of years to take place in an organism. Many times, habitat provides animals with food, shelter, and water. All of us know they are animals need these things for their survival. And our earth has a variety of habitats. So different kinds of animals live in different habitats, Therefore, based on their habitat, animals, we can divide animals into terrestrial, aquatic, amphibians, arboreal, and aerial animals. So children, as the name suggests, terrestrial, aquatic, amphibian, arboreal, and aerial, all the animals are destined to live in their different environment, means terrestrial on land, aquatic means in water, amphibian means on land and in water, arboreal means on trees, and aerial means in air. So all the animals are categorized according to the environment they are destined to live in. But one thing is most important to know, that the animals are divided according to their environment, but all the animals living in different environment and different habitats have their own adaptability to survive in that environment. So what are these adaptability? Because the process of changing to survive in the environment is called adaptation. So if we talk about the adaptation, a camel, for example, has developed long eyelashes to protect its eyes from sand in the desert. We will discuss a lot the desert adaptability of a camel and all the animals that live in desert. But animals that adapt themselves to these changes survive. Animals that are not able to adapt to the changes die out slowly. So, terrestrial animals have different adaptability to survive in terrestrial environment. Aquatic animals are having different adaptability to survive in aquatic medium. Amphibians are having different adaptability, having both kinds of breathing organs. When they are in water, they breathe through their skin. When they are on land, they breathe through their lungs. And arboreal animals are having different adaptability in their limbs to survive on trees. And aerial animals, you all of us know, they are having the four limbs changes into wings to survive for the aerial life. So children, we will discuss in this chapter the different words that you must be acquainted before we are going to discuss the chapter in detail. Your words are habitat, that is defined as the place where an animal or plant lives. Adaptation, the process of change undergone by an organism to be able to survive in different conditions. Terrestrial animals means animals that live on land. Aerial animals, animals that fly in air. Children, we will come to know a word that is aestivation. It is also a kind of adaptability. Adaptability for what? For the change in the season. Harsh climatic change for an animal. So they normally go to resting state of some animals to avoid hot and dry conditions. To avoid the hot and dry conditions, some animals go for aestivation, that is the resting state, and thus opposite word of aestivation is hibernation. When it is extreme cold for some animals, there is resting state for some animals to avoid extreme cold is called hibernation. And the migration, movement of animals from one place to another for feeding, breeding, or to escape harsh weather conditions. So, to move from one place to another, to avoid the scarcity of food, to breed and to escape the harsh climatic change is called migration. And we will come to know in this chapter the categorization of animals on the basis of their nutritional habit. So that is, that maybe they may be herbivores, they may be carnivores, they may be, you can say, omnivores and parasites. Parasites? What are parasites? Animals that live on or inside the body of other organisms for food and shelter. So we will come to know in detail about these words, and we will come to know about the camouflage, the ability of an animal to blend with their surroundings. Why? To escape from the predator, to protect themselves from the predators. So children, we know about the chameleon that can change its color when it sits on a tree. It can change its color of its body according to the color of the stem and the leaves. So that is the ability to avoid the predators, and this is the ability of animal to blend with their surroundings is called camouflage. So children, we will come to know about the endangered animals like dolphin, that is also an endangered animals, because all of us know there are dams construction that for that reason the life of dolphin come to an endangered conditions, animal that are in danger of becoming extinct. So this is also the announcement of government for dolphin is the national aquatic animal, and the river of the Ganga river also is a habitat of dolphin, and it is being protected, and many more words we will come to know about the amphibian, aerial, arboreal, scavengers, parasites, and we will come to know in this chapter. So before we go to discuss this chapter and before we go to understand this chapter, we must come to know about these words. So you have to learn these words and you have to define these words. And when we will discuss this chapter, we will come to know about all the new words of this chapter.